Hello everybody, Shadow here, and welcome back to the Somnium Files nirvanA initiative. Last time, we did Komeiji's Somnium, and then helped Komeiji rescue Shoma with the help of the three people here, Mizuki, the Masked Woman, and Date!
That's Addo Rabbit.
How do you know?
Well...
Because Mizuki is collecting the merch?
No! Duh.
Right.
Looks like there's something inside.
Magazines.
Oh my.
Mr. Date, those magazines and the speaker.
Oh, those. Those are, academic journals I collect as a hobby.
Right.
Because they're expensive limited editions. What if a robber broke in and stole them, huh?
Right. Okay, corkboard.
Date, the hard drive was full again. I had to make space, so I deleted all your cuckoldry videos.
Oh my!
First, I told you, those are husbandry videos. Second, why? Why did you do that?
They probably weren't husbandry videos, were they?
Nope.
Oh, I love the voice acting in this game. I wish I could replay that. Hold on. Wait, no, I can't replay that dialogue. I can't replay that dialogue.
First, I told you, those are husbandry videos. Second,
why? Why did you do that?
It's just that last part. I love the voice acting.
Mr. Date, you can lift this?
That's Mizuki's.
Huh? Oh, right.
That's not that surprising. We did just see her in action.
Right. It's a big window.
Hey, don't I always tell you not to hang your clothes there? I don't want your old people smell getting on my stuff.
I told you I can't help it. So what if I like oatmeal?
Mr. Date, I don't think that's what she said.
Beautiful. School bag.
She'll only be carrying that for another month or so.
Right. Okay. Small window. Kitchen. Sofa. Table. Bed.
Miyuki,
rug.
Don't look under that rug.
Why not? I immediately looked under that rug. Cooking magazines were hidden underneath. There are cooking magazines under the rug for some reason. That's a little weird.
For what?
If you didn't show up when you did, I don't think we could have saved Shoma.
Right.
So...
Don't sweat it. That was nothing to me. Well, Date...
Yeah, I asked her to help. I couldn't get there right away, so I sent Mizuki instead.
Okay.
I told her not to start the fight until I got there, but...
Not like I had a choice. Shoma was about to be taken away in that van.
That is fair.
Excuse me?
Miyuki, you better not be getting any funny ideas.
No, it's not about me.
It's about Shoma.
It's about Shoma. I thought you and him are kind of a nice match. If you don't have a boyfriend... Why don't you and Shoma...
Well, first of all, Ryuki, don't make assumptions.
What? Are you stupid?
I mean, clearly, Shoma has a crush.
I don't know what you're talking about. It's inexplicable, incomprehensible, impossible.
And inconceivable.
Even if I were to reincarnate 100 million times, the possibility of that happening...
Here.
What?
It's chocolate. Delagira chocolate. Because it's Valentine's Day and all.
Thanks.
Well, that's sweet.
You're welcome.
Would you look at that? Shoma's a ladies' man. Makes sense, considering he's got my blood in him.
Aren't you divorced? Okay. Let's do... Komeiji.
Like I told you, it's nothing to worry about. little injury like this won't bother me now that Shoma's back.
Right.
Though, there is something I lost in all this.
Okay.
I seem to have dropped something at the warehouse district. It was something very precious to me. Well, anyway, don't worry about it.
Okay.
You gain some, you lose some. That's just how it is.
I assume it's the little, like, ornament thing that Shoma ripped in half, right?
This is all thanks to you, Mr. Ryuki. And, of course, everyone else here.
Right.
Thank you all so much. Wait, Mr. Ryuki. Not in front of Shoma.
Fair enough. Who's moving now?
Okay, we can talk about it.
Okay, we are.
Why are you bringing this up now?
I was just a bit curious as to why you took on so much debt. Is it related to women, by chance?
What?
For example, maybe you're addicted to cabaret clubs.
What's that?
Dante! Dante!
I thought I heard something. Couldn't just ignore it.
How do you have such good hearing?
He just reacts to certain keywords.
Yeah.
So, what's this about cabaret clubs?
I was just saying that Komeiji might be...
Don't be ridiculous! There's no way I could be addicted to something like that.
But Date clearly is.
Speaking of, Komeiji, I heard you're a regular at Sunfish Pocket.
What?
Busted.
A friend of mine told me you go there all the time. According to him, there's a mermaid there that you're really into.
Ah, so you know. You got me. I'm embarrassed to admit I'm so into maid cafes at this age. But yes, you're right. I go there often, but the money problem has nothing to do with that.
Okay.
The debt is from my living expenses. That's just how little I've been earning lately.
Okay.
In order to pay my debt, I had to borrow even more.
Okay.
Before I knew it, the interest snowballed out of control.
That is usually how it goes, yes.
Anyway, I don't want to talk about this right now, so please.
All right, everybody back to your seats. Okay, let's talk to Date.
I contacted him before going to the warehouse district.
Oh, that's very smart.
It's always good to have allies backing you up, right?
Fair.
But Mr. Date is on vacation.
If my precious subordinate is in trouble, I'll come flying to the rescue.
Well, thank you.
Thank you. You've always been so good to me. I've always wanted to repay you somehow, but I...
Don't worry about it. As long as I have breath in my lungs, I won't need your help.
Okay.
But when I die someday, I'll need you to do me a solid.
All right.
When I die, I want you to wipe the hard drive on my computer.
How about I bust it open for you right now?
No, please don't.
Okay.
Oh, that. It awoke in me in third grade. I was walking alone through a deep forest behind my elementary school.
Right.
It was my shortcut to get home. When suddenly, inside a depression behind some bushes, I noticed a lone magazine.
Okay.
It was a porno mag someone threw away. The pages were all crusty and whatnot.
Ew.
I crouched down, and my heart was pounding in my ears as I turned the pages, using a branch. Anyway, that's when it happened. I felt a stinging pain on my right ankle. I jumped up in surprise, and there, I saw a white snake.
Okay.
I didn't know what kind. I was just a kid. But even then, I could tell. That snake had deadly venom. About 3 seconds later, I was out like a light.
Okay.
They found me out there the next morning. I was on the verge of death for 3 days and three nights, but I managed to pull through.
Okay.
And that is how I acquired my portal mag powers.
How does that make any sense?
You mean it was a side effect from the snake venom?
No. It was more of a mental thing. I had a near-death experience immediately after experiencing a porno mag for the first time.
I see.
As a result, Eros and Thanatos inside me, Libido and Destrudo, they merged together in total harmony.
I see.
In other words, I've come to be acutely aware of death whenever I get aroused.
I see.
To put it in even simpler terms, I'm pushed to the verge of death whenever I see a porno mag.
All right.
You know how humans can exert tremendous power in life or death situations?
Right.
It's because the adrenaline triggers a fight or flight response.
I can just imagine everyone else's thoughts during this. The The masked woman's just like, why did I help these people? Shoma's just like, who is this person? Should I be sitting on their couch?
Same thing happens when I see a porno mag. My brain's processing speed increases by 3.6 times in order to avoid death, dramatically improving my reflexes.
Right. Shine new Kobe.
Sorry. I know that story was dark. As if I've touched upon a great evil.
I mean, you are talking about porno mags in front of a kid.
You're touched in the head.
Yeah.
You touch upon my great evil.
I want to see Date and Tama working together. I want to bear witness to that cursed energy.
You nearly die when you see porno mags, don't you? So then why?
Ah, excellent question. I'll answer with a question of my own. Why does a mountain climber seek the top of the tallest peaks? Why does a surfer want to ride the most monstrous of waves?
Okay.
Why do people climb up the highest buildings to do parkour or whatever?
Kind of losing us on the last one
there.
Why
do they do such reckless things?
For the thrill?
Yeah, it's how they know they're alive. They can experience firsthand the wonder of life itself.
Okay.
That is the reason I continue to climb the mountain known as pornography.
I see.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna change my last name.
Oof.
I think that would be a good idea.
Ouch.
She still hasn't come home. Supposedly, she's on a top secret mission from Boss.
Right.
Yeah, I was just thinking about Leon. I was with him in Golden Yokocho right before I went to the warehouse district.
Okay.
That's right. You know him, too.
I met him when I was drinking at Brahmin.
Right.
One thing led to another, and we started talking about each other's collection of literature.
Right. Literature.
He seemed pretty proud of his collection. As two kindred souls sharing the same hobby, we lost track of time discussing our love of reading.
Right.
He even promised to trade our most precious belongings.
Fair
enough. We've been sworn brothers ever since. Oh,
okay.
But that's not what we're talking about today. There was something I wanted to ask him about the HB case.
I see.
You've been investigating too, Mr. Date?
I'm on vacation, so I'm just doing it on my own time. I can't get this case out of my head.
Right. Oh, hold on. Sorry. Which do you want to befriend? Well, if you become its friend, bring it to Sunfish Pockety. You know what? I will. That's the goal.
Certain rumor regarding Horidori Institute.
Okay. I asked Mr. Date about the discussion, but it was all information I already had. I didn't learn anything new.
No matter how you slice it, there's no doubt
why is my throat being scratchy right now?
Involved in the case somehow.
Right.
Yes. The Institute and Terror are closely related. The previous incident proves it.
Correct.
But what's their connection?
The QR video was based on Bats 490.
Right.
And Bats 490 was created by Nyes on Tokiko's orders. Tokiko knew the director of Horidori Institute, Chikara Horidori.
Right.
In other words, Nyes, Tokiko, Chikara, and Horidori Institute are all connected.
Huh.
And Terror is somewhere in there.
Correct.
Or maybe Terror is the one who's orchestrating it all.
Right.
Me?
Yes.
No, there's not much I want to say.
Okay.
I don't want to confuse you by telling you something that I don't know for sure.
Fair enough.
I'll let you know once I get a bit more info.
Okay.
I didn't go there. I was there already.
Ah.
What?
I'd rather not have to deal with you laboring under a false impression. So I'll give you some information.
Okay.
I've been independently looking into the genome editing research at Horidori Institute.
All right.
At Horidori Institute?
Yes. I've been trying to get a handle on the movements of the researchers there.
Okay.
They made their move just a few hours ago.
Good to know.
They mobilized a big group of them into the warehouse district. So I climbed on a crane and watched the events unfold.
You mean you were just watching as Ryuki and I were fighting?
Right.
Yes. But I realized that if I didn't step in, the old man and his boy would be killed. That's why I helped. Aren't I generous?
Thank you. You thank her too, Shoma.
Okay.
I told you I'd give you some information.
Sorry, I need a drink of water because my throat is being a pain in the butt. Which is weird because it's my throat, not my butt.
That's the extent of what I'll tell you.
Why?
Because someone here may be leaking intel to the Institute.
Oh dear. I nearly told her that's ridiculous, then stopped myself. Because... Right?
No, I will not.
Fair?
Well, I guess it would be more accurate to say I cannot. Not yet.
Ah.
This mask is secured in place by an extremely powerful special adhesive developed by NASA.
Oh.
If you try to take it off by force, it would take my skin with it.
Dang.
What? Come on.
That sounds really bad for your skin.
Right.
You said not yet, right?
Yes, there is a way to remove it.
So why not do it now?
I am a woman of beauty beyond compare. If I remove this mask, blood would erupt from the noses of the four men here, and they would die of blood loss.
Okay.
In other words, I'm saving your lives by keeping this mask on.
Sure.
Quite kind of me. Wouldn't you agree? Time. I'm thinking about the passage of time.
Okay.
Time?
Time goes by so quickly.
Right.
Seriously, what is with that woman?
She helped us earlier, but that doesn't necessarily mean we can trust her.
Right, especially because in 6 years, she's shooting at Mizuki.
Why don't you take a peek?
Winxing, huh?
That's smart. We're not gonna be able to see anything.
Today is February 11th, National Foundation Day, isn't it? But the doctor decided to give you a special consultation anyway. You should thank him. But I have to say, the doctor is at fault too.
Okay.
That was a bit harsh. Oh, well, about your remaining life expectancy.
Okay.
This may not offer much comfort coming from me, but please don't feel too down. The doctor's diagnosis isn't always correct.
That was...
She seems to have some sort of illness.
Okay, so that's why she's interested in the research.
Why do you ask?
No reason.
You saw me fight earlier, didn't you? I'm perfectly healthy.
Right.
There's nothing wrong with me.
Totally.
That's good.
All right, Shoma.
I'm fine, but really, I guess I should thank you.
Probably, yes.
Thank you for saving me.
Did you say thanks to your dad?
I don't need to hear him say it. As long as Shoma is safe, that's all I want.
Well, that's sweet.
I was at home, and those people in the suits, they came barging in.
Okay, right.
And then they made me inhale some kind of knockout gas. When I woke up, I was in that warehouse.
Okay.
Did they ask you anything?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't remember. Maybe it's because of the gas. I was groggy the whole time.
Okay. Understandable. I told Shoma about the fact that I looked inside Komeiji's head, and that I saw the envelope containing Horidori Institute's secret documents there.
Can you tell me how you're linked to Horidori Institute?
That would be very helpful.
Shoma, answer him.
Sorry, but I don't want to talk about that.
Why not?
Because I don't. I burned it, so I don't have it anymore.
Okay. Are you lying?
I asked a lot of questions, but what I'm most curious about is the relationship between Shoma and Horidori Institute.
Right.
Do you intend to sink?
It's all I can do.
What about the hospital?
How long do you think I can last?
You do realize that you should be getting medical attention as soon as possible?
Right.
But I guess there's no point trying to convince you.
Yeah.
And you're going to do it anyway, aren't you?
Thank you. I'm blessed to have such an understanding partner.
Jeez.
Shoma, there's one thing I want to ask you. Will you let me look inside your mind?
What?
Shoma? I think it's a good idea, too.
Okay.
Could you help Mr. Ryuki out?
But this is all out of nowhere.
Why not help him? Ryuki and your dad saved your life.
Right, we did do that.
You need to repay the debts you owe. It's just the right thing to do.
Right.
Fine. Then...
I mean, are we in such a hurry? Couldn't we go get our wound checked out and then go sink? Apparently not.
The machine looks pretty intimidating seeing it like this.
Right.
I'm getting a bit nervous.
But you already have experience with it. There's nothing to worry about.
By the way, about Horidori Institute. We started searching the place.
Okay.
We have the staff in custody now, and they're being questioned over at HQ.
Good to know.
But they're all refusing to talk.
Right.
It's going to take some time to get info out of them.
Yeah, that's to be expected.
Ryuki, about your shoulder.
It's fine. Please begin.
Pewter.
Very well.
Here we go into the mind of a child.
Ryuki, are you ready?
Yes, I'm good to go.
All right then. Let's begin.
Da 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 da! Into the brain of Shoma! Okay. What do we got going on here? That is fair. Oh. Okay, interesting.
This is Shoma's house.
Right.
A stereotypical home. Hey, Tama. Can you pretend to be a newlywed wife?
Why?
Why?
I'll give you 4,000 yen.
That's an eerily specific amount.
Right.
Please. I need you to be a wife.
Ryuki.
Fine, I'll do it. Hi, baby. I was waiting for you.
Do you want some dinner? Or a bath? Or maybe... meat?
Thank you. Magnifico.
All right.
Anyway, this dream world is a little dull.
Right.
Yeah, there's a melancholy feel to it. Maybe this is Shoma's state of mind.
Right.
He's holding something dark inside. In cases like this, if we solve his somnium, he might open up to us.
It's possible.
Yeah, good idea. And we might find out how Horidori Institute is involved in all this.
Okay. Somnium. Let's take a look.
Activate.
Okay. To lock 1, 2, 3, 4. Is there a fifth? There's a fifth. Okay. Recover Shoma's memories. Shoma seems to know the secret of Horidori Institute. By repairing his wounded heart, you might discover repressed memories. Okay. This is probably a bad idea, but I think we are going to do the Somnium now. We'll probably have to end immediately after the Somnium is done. But we'll see.
That's the suit Andy's Komeiji always wears.
Is this all he has?
Tickle, tickle, tickle. Tickle, tickle, tickle. Hey, you like this, right? Tickle, tickle.
Okay, well, that didn't do anything.
I know this was my idea, but it was a bad idea.
Right.
I thought Shoma might have a memory of being tickled, but it didn't work.
Should we be more direct?
It's possible. Shoma used to blank, but blank to the world, but blank. Okay. Yeah, this is the only thing we can interact with.
Meiji's outfit.
Let's cut this by a fourth and go to joke.
Nothing is better to heal Shoma's heart than a smile, so...
Okay, leave it to me.
Dad! Dad! Why did you disappear on me?
Literally disappear?
So this is a brand new 10,000 yen bill.
This world is becoming more and more cashless.
Look! An invisible man!
Oh no!
No, he's just naked from the waist down.
Oh no!
You know, this might have the opposite effect.
Right.
Why? People watching on the TV were going crazy.
Shoma's dad is so unfunny.
Huh? Yeah, Andy's Kameji sucks. And you've never made us laugh either.
Not everyone has to make people laugh.
Hold on. We used to...
Yeah, lameness must be genetic. So true. Now that's funny. We don't want to contract your unfunny disease, so we're gonna stay away from you.
Wow. Kids are cruel.
Stupid dad. Why me?
This happened to Shoma.
Even from a young age, he's had a rough.
Yeah.
I hate this world. It's all fake. Only thing I can believe in is the world I make.
Okay.
Shoma rejected the real world. He decided he belonged in a world of his own creation.
Right.
For him, the world he created was the real world.
Okay.
Hey, we can inspect that model.
Let's take a look. Used to blank, but closed his heart. Okay. Inspect, and we're gonna get sucked into it.
House?
Whoopsie.
Tama, you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Oh, hi.
Is that Shoma from earlier?
Seems like he went inside that model.
It looks just like Shoma's house from earlier, but the colors are more vibrant here.
Right.
Maybe that symbolizes his belief that this artificial world is the real world.
Okay.
Those are the clothes Shoma ripped up earlier, but it looks like cardboard.
Right.
Maybe it's a wound in Shoma's heart.
I bet we have to do something with this. Let's fix it.
Okay. Shoma began blank and became blank. Actions in his blank, blank as well. Scissors. Tape. Let's use tape.
The best thing for fixing a tear? Tape.
I did it!
Hooray!
It turned back to the original outfit.
We used to play together.
God of energy! Inti! Inti! Pachaka Max!
We used to laugh together.
Hey! That's no fair!
Laughed.
Okay.
Hold up! Andy's is the best!
Stupid dad.
Interesting. But it's not cool. Shoma began making his own world and became... Okay. Right.
I wonder if that really happened.
Maybe he tucked away the good memories in the world he created.
It's possible.
The painful memories were played too, not just the good memories.
Yeah. Poor kid's heart.
Right.
Even deep down, those painful memories remain. Shoma and his dad need to have an honest heart-to-heart.
Right.
Huh? Looks like we made it out of the model.
Right, okay. Time for the TV, presumably.
It's an older model TV.
What's protruding out of the top?
It looks like a spout or something.
Okay.
So we need to pour something in there?
I don't know. Maybe it's just for show.
I'm gonna do inspect to get that equals 10. Can we take it apart with a screwdriver?
Huh? There aren't any screws.
Wait, this...
You got something?
It's ceramic.
Ceramic? It looks like a normal TV.
The outside is ceramic. What is this?
Interesting.
This is creepy.
Looks like we can take it apart.
So, Shoma began making his own world and became detached from reality. Actions in his creation blank as well.
A TV.
Let's go ahead and laugh.
You want me to laugh at the TV?
Sure.
Yeah. I was thinking it could bring back memories of the father and son laughing together.
Okay.
Hey!
Huh? I heard laughter from the TV.
Should we turn it on?
Probably. Shoma used to laugh a lot, but closed his heart to the world, but
Ryuki,
blank.
Ryuki, you have 5 minutes left.
Okay.
A TV.
Let's use that.
And just like that.
There we go.
Shoma.
God of laughter, lucky happy Punchaka Max! Look at what you did. You really ruined the atmosphere.
Oh dear.
God of apologies. Sorry.
Enough already. You're past your prime. I can't even stand you.
Oh dear. Oh!
That was so uncool. Why does he have to be my dad?
Wow.
That's what comes from being a comedian's son, I guess.
Right.
But he shouldn't blame Kameiji for that.
Okay, I guess we're going back inside.
I wonder if we can change Shoma's heart by going inside the model.
But deep down, he still loves to laugh. Okay. Dive in to the model!
Alright, we made it back into the model.
Come to think of it, we haven't found anything on Horridori Institute yet.
Right.
We need to help Shoma first.
Good point. We can't leave him like this. Huh. Is that...
Shoma was stabbing it with the screwdriver earlier. Did the hole get bigger?
We should fix this, too.
Right, okay. So we need to find something to fix the hole. Actions in his creation impact the outside world as well. Hold on. What haunted spot would you like to go to? Ruins, graveyard, old battlefield, mountains. Probably ruins. That sounds like a good option. Alright, well, there's a suitcase.
This is probably Kameiji's suitcase.
I'm guessing it's for his props.
Okay. Let's go ahead and open.
Phew. No good. It's not opening.
Fair enough.
Kameiji's...
Let's throw it?
Where should I throw this?
Over there somewhere.
Yeah.
Jeepers, creepers. Okay.
It came back.
That's unexpected.
The suitcase isn't even broken.
Oh. Cool.
Meiji's suitcase.
I guess we can go on vacation? Sure.
Huh?
Suitcases are used for travel, right? Maybe Shoma has memories of going on a trip. give me a line.
Yeah, sure. Shoma, we're going to Machu Picchu. I'm gonna train my comedy skills at a World Heritage Site.
I see. Nothing.
Wait, can they even afford to go to Machu Picchu?
I never specified Machu Picchu.
Right. Okay, well, that didn't help.
Mages.
Of course, it's the last It's really Tickle? Okay.
Tickle, tickle, tickle. Tickle, tickle, tickle.
Stop! It tickles!
He's laughing so much.
Okay.
There's something inside.
A drawing of Komeiji's face?
I wonder if Shoma drew it.
That's nice.
4 minutes now.
It's a drawing of Komeiji's face.
Let's go cut out.
Cut it out. You idiot! I can't cut something important like this.
Jeez, you don't have to yell. I have an idea. Can you cut out just his face?
If this ends up hurting Shoma, I'm going to cut your face out.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, done.
Perfect.
Try covering the hole in the TV with it.
Exactly what I wanted it to be.
God of apologies! Sorry! Enough already! You're past your prime. I can't even stand you! God of seasons! Warm, hot, chilly, cold! Wow, you're just forcing it now. You're past your prime.
He has no sense for comedy. Why does he try so hard?
Aww. This is gonna be sad. I mean, it already is sad. Remembered my feelings of support. Doesn't fit.
He's conflicted. He wants him to do well, but he doesn't want to see him anymore.
Right.
We came back.
Why am I laughing? This isn't how I really feel. This can't be true. It's all lies.
No, it's not.
Shoma is confused.
Huh. We can't go inside the model anymore. The sign for interaction is gone too. Maybe
okay.
Shoma is starting to accept reality.
It's possible.
Right. We did fix a lot of things. He's starting to comprehend what's real and what's artificial.
Okay. Notebook.
It says something. Let's see. Your dad is not funny. From now on, your name is Lamo Enda. Nice to meet you, Lamo Enda.
These stupid kids! Fuck off! Stop making fun of him!
Relax.
Yeah!
This isn't real. It's all fake. Everything in this world is fake. All fake. I'm fake. Everything is fake.
Okay. Oh dear.
Yeah. That's it. I just need to make everything fake.
I don't believe it.
Shoma.
This is not reality. Maybe on the other side.
I thought we were close to a breakthrough, but his imagination is running
okay.
away with him even more.
I can understand how he got interested in knives and stuff.
This house we're in is just a model. No, everything is fake. This made-up world is fake. Reality itself is fake. Everything is fake. There's nothing we can do.
What? Why are you giving up, huh?
We still have time!
We can figure this out.
You're right. It's too early to give up.
We got this. Shoma started to dislike blank and stopped blank. I assume started to dislike school and stopped going. Linguistics. Worn out notebook. Let's try
Mrs.
a worn
Kameji's
out notebook.
Mrs. Comedy material notebook. It's really worn out.
Let's go with fix with tape.
That makes sense. The notebook is ripped. It's done.
Dang.
This can't be fixed normally.
Do we even need to fix the notebook?
Oh. Shoma started to dislike his name and stopped. Stopped responding to it.
This is Kameji.
I wanna... Okay.
He's a comedian after all, so maybe we should do something comedic.
Hit it with a folding fan? No, we need a setup. Let me read the notebook.
Okay.
When Shoma was little, I asked him a math question. Shoma, you have 5 oranges right now.
Okay.
Mom came and gave you 2 oranges.
Right.
If I ask you to give me 3 oranges, how many oranges will you have?
Okay.
And Shoma said 7.
He's so funny.
That's actually pretty good.
Oh, the notebook is fixed.
We did it.
Oh, sorry. I was just thinking about getting some rice balls with bonito flakes.
Concentrate on work. And you don't need to put bonito flakes on it. There's already toppings.
Got it. The notebook is fixed, but it doesn't look like it has to do with anything.
Right.
Maybe the clue is something in Shoma's name.
Okay.
Is that...
Eyeball!
It's a linguistics textbook. It says Enda on it.
Fix with pen, fix with scissors. What's up? Let me look at the other ones.
Science
notebook.
Textbook. There's no name on it.
Fixed with magnifying glass, fixed with screwdriver. Let's try the
fix
screwdriver.
It like you're turning a screw.
There are no screws.
Just try it.
What even is the point of this?
All right, let's try something else.
Okay.
I hope you would have noticed earlier.
And stopped writing his name on his belongings. Okay, so I feel like the science notebook is clearly one that we're supposed to, yeah.
It's a science.
Science notebook is clearly one of the right ones to go for because the...
How are we supposed to fix this?
The linguistics notebook had Enda on it.
Why don't you flip through it first?
Whoa! It's on fire!
Oh dear!
Extinguisher!
Ta-da!
Oh, the notebook is fixed.
You're right. That's it, though. Nothing special about it.
Okay.
I'm sure it has something to do with being picked on because of his name.
Right.
His name, huh?
You have 3 minutes left, Ryuki. Focus.
Got it.
It's a social studies textbook. It's barely been used.
Fixed with whiteout, fixed with toy hammer. Let's go with the toy hammer.
This isn't gonna fix anything.
Darn.
It's a social...
Okay, fix with whiteout.
There's nothing written in it, so there's nothing to be fixed with whiteout.
Just smear some more on there.
At random?
Ta-da!
Huh, it got fixed. What happened?
I get it. You fixed history.
Okay.
And...
well,
according to Shoma's memory, I think it has to do with his name.
Right.
His name, huh?
So we're just... I think we're just fixing... oh, have I been barking up the wrong tree? Have I... do I need to fix this one?
It's a linguist.
And the other ones are... fakes? Is that what's going on?
Cut it more.
Yeah. Maybe that will do something.
All right. I'll try it.
Snip, snip. Whoa!
That was close.
Cutting up someone's notebook is pretty messed up.
Yeah. We should do something else.
Okay. Shoma blank. However, now he blank and has blank.
It's a linguist.
Oh. Hold on. The fix with pen was on the left before. That's weird.
How do I fix this with a pen?
Reenact how it was used and maybe it'll fix itself.
Let's practice some handwriting. Tub, 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 butt, butt.
You're turning your tubs into butts.
Okay.
What's going on?
The note got fixed, but nothing else is special about it.
Yeah.
He was bullied because of his name. Maybe that's a clue.
Right.
Tubby.
Forget about the butts.
Oh, you meant Shoma.
Okay, so we do just need to fix all of them, because there's nothing else we can interact with besides these notebooks. So.
It's a math notebook. Part of it is blacked out.
Fixed with eraser, fixed with glue. Let's try fixed with eraser.
I'm going to erase the blacked out parts.
Shoma Enda.
There we go.
Dad, why is my name Shoma?
Oh, you want to know how you got your name? You know, I actually wanted to spell the show part of your name with the kanji for laughter. It was going to be spelled with the character for laughter and shine, like a shining smile. But okay. When I told your sister, she said, why don't you use it as your stage name? I need to brush up on my comedy.
Yeah, you do.
Everybody's a critic. Anyway, I decided to change the kanji for your name.
Okay.
The kanji for show can be congratulatory or mean happiness.
Okay, I see.
I was so happy when you were born, I made it a part of your name. But to me, you still have the laughter in there, because I wanted you to stay smiling forever. Oh, this is so embarrassing. Stop making me talk about it.
Aww.
God of shyness. Oh, no, please. Not the spotlight.
Stop that.
Oh, sorry.
Laughter and happiness.
Aww.
But smiling doesn't suit me.
Yes, it does. Remembered who Shoma is inside. Okay. Two more locks. I don't want to accept it, but Shoma believes Nia's teachings and believes the world is fake. By suppressing his feelings, the world has lost its color. Okay.
I think it's a good name. That's why smiles suit him well.
Yeah. We need to convince him.
I don't need this memory. I don't need this name. It all hurts. I'm not even real. The world, Dad, it's all fake.
Ooh. Oh, the rooftop amusement park.
The barber said they're waiting for the ear to come on down. God of haircut, snip, snip, whoops, got your ear.
Stop. It's not funny.
Oh, dear.
A lot of factors led to him becoming an introvert.
Right.
I'd like to fix every little thing, but the trophy Shoma destroyed disappeared.
Can you find something like it? There has to be something.
Okay. We can look. Okay, the robot's back. Dresser.
A refrigerator.
I want to open the door.
Prop comedy!
I'm gonna do a prop skit, Tama.
Again?
It'll be good this time.
It's gonna bring back some sad memories again.
All right, I'm going to escape this uninhabited island on this.
That's a raft?
What? A third form?
An enemy who gets stronger when they get smaller?
Oh dear!
What time do you think it is?
Morning. In the Showa era.
Hey, look! This is squishy.
A kind of mighty hammer.
Okay.
Oh, Mama. You have a place here too?
Marble's second branch. Whew. Seems like the grading skill for laughs was lower this time.
Right.
Maybe it was always open. Oh, it's a ripped piece of paper.
Let's leave it on top of the kotatsu.
Right, okay. So we got one of them. Shoma blank, however, now he blank and has thrown away that memory. Okay.
It's a monowheel robot Shoma made.
There's something under the tire.
Oh dear.
I wonder if it'll move out of the way.
Beat up, smile. Let's smile.
Yeah. It may only be a robot, but we need to show it love.
Right.
Hey, Mr. Robot. Get out of the way.
You're downright bipolar.
Right. Oh. Well,
oh,
thank you.
It's reacting.
It's a ripped piece of paper.
Let's leave it on top of the kotatsu.
Perfect. Shoma blank. However, now he does not accept his dad and has thrown away that memory. And now we need to find one in the dresser.
Wish we could look inside.
Comedy duo! Make him laugh. Let's go comedy duo.
What do you want me to do?
Just go with the flow. Do it.
Your instructions are way too vague. The other day, I hit my heart on the corner of the dresser and I thought my pinky toe was gonna explode. Other way around!
Well, that worked.
Hey, do you think we could have just opened it normally?
Probably.
I guess we could have.
There's something inside.
Ripped origami?
Let's leave it on top of the kotatsu.
Shoma gave his dad a gift to support him, however, now he does not accept his dad and has thrown away that memory. Okay.
This ripped paper must have some significance to it.
Should we try to repair it?
Probably.
You only have 2 minutes. Hurry, Ryuki.
I'm aware. Also, hold on. What do you think of mermaids? Cute, slimy, get excited, pretty! Alright. Now let's fix this thing.
It is one sheet. The tears match up.
Let's try putting it together.
Fix with scissors, fix with eraser, fix with pen, fix with tape. Let's go with fix with tape.
Tape, of course.
It's probably not going to be that simple, but let's try. Oh, no, it was that simple. Okay. Kind of impressive.
Good luck, Dad.
Oh dear! Oh no! We've fallen out
this
of the model.
Lies. It's fake. I don't want to see it anymore. It always hurts. They made fun of me. I'm nothing. Save me, please.
Save me! Make the hurt go away! I need to get out. I need to escape these lies! Why?
Hi.
Why does everything look like so real? If it wasn't fake. If it was real the whole time. Is my pain real too?
It's a very good question. Well? We have gotten the second to last lock. And I think we got a quick stop here. We gotta cut the episode. I don't want these to go too terribly long. But yeah. So I think stopping here before the last thing is probably a good idea.
Yeah, somehow. I didn't think that memory was going to be that bad. Why did Shoma have such a negative reaction?
It's a very good question.
Sometimes the best memories make the hurtful ones worse. If you're not in a good place, the last thing you want to do is look back on all the times that were better.
Right.
Shoma doesn't want to see how he was back then. Back before his heart was broken. That's how he stays sane.
That must be hard.
Okay, well, before we continue on... There we go. That's what I want to do. Before we continue on, we're going to stop the episode. Because usually after Somnium's like this, you just kind of dive straight into more story. And as such, I'm not going to finish the Somnium until after an hour has passed. If I continue the episode as it is now. And then I'm going to have to find a place to stop. Which I probably won't get right away. So, I'm going to stop here, right before we get the climax of the Somnium. And then we can just keep rolling directly into more story, and all that good stuff. So, that is my decision, and I'm sticking to it! That being said, if you liked anything in this episode, please go ahead and leave a like, maybe let me know in the comments down below. And if you want to catch the next episode, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Thank you very much for your consideration in that, and thank you for watching. So, I will see you next time! I don't know what I'm doing with my face! Buh-bye!